What's going on? You locked in with the Innovators YouTube. You already know I got the best interviews right here, man. We at the Fairfield I Love You store, and we got Bijan right here. What's going on, bro?
What's up with you, King? What's up with you, man? We here with legendary super producer Don Bailey. Fairfield I Love You store, Fairfield, California. You know we got to bring him here, too, right?
Yeah.
You got to come see what's up. Feel me?
How's everything going for you today? How you doing?
Man. It's a beautiful day, man. I'm breathing. We woke up, so we here speaking to you.
It's nice today.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
It was actually very nice today, for sure. How did you grow up? Were your parents around? Like, what was that like?
Yeah, Fairfield, California. Growing up, grandma, filming, grandma household, grandpa, moms. Pops wasn't there for the most part, but he was in and out, you feel me? In and out of our lives in terms of coming in and whatnot. Yeah, but growing up in Fairfield, pretty much me and bro. And yeah, you feel me? Shout out to my family too, you feel me? Big family, Deloach family. If you're in Fairfield, you know the Deloach family.
Yeah.
Yeah, Fairfield. Fairfield.
What about you? How'd you grow up?
Fairfield. military.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, my dad was military. Moved out to the edge, like almost below, like Cordelia. If you live in Fairfield, but over there for since like 09, just been over here chilling ever since. Played baseball
yeah.
my whole life. Got into music when I was like 16. And just been up since there, so.
How would y'all describe Fairfield to someone who's never been here?
Promising.
Promising. That's a good way to say it. The future. Yeah. Fairfield future.
Expanding.
Expanding, growing. Yeah. In the middle of it all.
Mm-hmm.
Militant about our money. You feel me? It's funny he said the military. You got to kind of have some military roots if you're from out here, right? At some point.
Oh, yeah.
For the most
kind
part.
Of, yeah.
For the most
yeah.
part. But yeah, it's exciting. I feel like it's getting more shine now. You feel me?
Mm-hmm. Suburban. In some parts. I don't know.
You think it look nice. You think it looks sweet. But it got its interesting parts.
Yeah.
For the most part, it's a lot of love.
Yeah, for sure.
Out here. It could always be more, but it's not too much hatred. It's not too much hatred. From other areas, it'd be some hatred. But if you're from Fairfield, it's pretty much love, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's how I take it.
This is what somebody was just discussing prior, but y'all can speak on this if you want. People, I guess some people are trying to say that Fairfield is not the Bay, which I think is crazy, but what's your take on that?
I think it's crazy, too, because everyone from the Bay comes to Fairfield.
It's pretty laughable at this point. I think if you got to say something to indicate if it's not the Bay, it's haters for a reason, right? You got to be a hater. There's characteristics of a hater, right? I'm the type that ain't gonna hate. I ain't gonna say nothing because what's understood don't need to be explained, right? So,
true.
If you know, if you've been in any type of Bay Area music scene, anything like that, you know about Fairfield. You know, there's some history out here. We can go down the line, but it's cool. Say whatever you want. We just gonna keep working. That's how we gonna respond to that, right?
Yeah. I mean, the culture out here feels like the Bay for the most part.
It do.
It feels more Bay than it feels like, I guess, Sac or whatever. But like, I don't know.
It do.
I think Fairfield's definitely the Bay.
Yeah.
Personally, I was actually surprised. I was like, really? That's what they're saying?
Yeah, right.
I mean, it was up for debate, right? Until I was on live, right?
Technically, geographically speaking.
Technically, right? But then if E40. The ambassador of the Bay Area is on live with Too Short, icon legend from the Bay Area, and says something about Fairfield, stopping. We stopping in Fairfield because that's the Bay Area.
nothing more.
I'm just gonna stop.
Said.
I'm just gonna stop. We don't need that. We're not gonna speak about Barefoot not being a bay no more. Forget it. It's over. So,
can we talk about the Fairfield I Love You movement? I know they can see the logo in the background. Like, how did that come about? Like, what's up with that?
Fairfield I Love You is a movement that's starts with, you know, love for the city. It started since I was raised out here, and just that pride of being from Fairfield, that's what it started as. And nobody really had a sense of pride for Fairfield. Like, I guess when I was growing up, or I guess nobody just wore that Fairfield. I guess it's probably only a few, maybe the Federation. Like Stress was adamant about saying 94533 in Fairfield. I'm from Fairfield, California, USA. So I think when I heard that, that was like the first time I heard a sense of pride for Fairfield, like a big rapper, and it kind of diminished. So it kind of started as a need to show love, to spread love for the city, because there's so many autonomous moving parts in Fairfield. So we try to bring everybody together with just under an umbrella of love, and that's Fairfield, I Love You. It don't matter what high school you came from, it don't matter what part of the city you from, it's literally all about putting shine to what we're doing in Fairfield. And you can tell by all our movements, you can tell by all our collaboration, you can tell by how we move. Yeah, it's not about me, it's not about bro, it's literally about the city of Fairfield and just having that sense of pride of being proud where you from.
Why do you feel people haven't pushed that they're from Fairfield as much as they could have in the past?
I think it's it could be a regional thing, whereas you kind of get boxed into a region. And I feel like at that time, it wasn't, everything wasn't accessible. Like, I couldn't go, it was literally MySpace or something like that. It wasn't like Instagram is right now. It wasn't so worldly. So you literally, if you was from the, any type of Bay centric, you was just gonna be swallowed up by the Bay. It wasn't no kind of Fairfield or anything like that. So I think that's kind of a reason why. I think, like, now you got the kind of small cities, small areas that you don't need to latch on to necessarily full Bay Area. You can really stay home, right? And I think some pockets in the Bay do that. Like, Vallejo is a place that really keeps Vallejo, right? Yeah. Richmond kind of keeps Richmond. The town kind of too. So city, I mean, you can go kind of other places, but I think because we weren't accepted, and just that need of, you know, validation sometimes, and we didn't really have it, so it's kind of hard to put it on the pedestal, right? So, I think now,
there was no one really labeling it as, like, cool to be from Fairfield.
Nobody, right? It was almost Squarefield. It's almost still like that until we started changing this narrative.
Squarefield.
Where does that come from, though?
It come from Vallejo, honestly. That's okay. Where it come from. It come from Vallejo, how I do it? No. Hold on, he passed me the red cup. You know? I think, I remember coming from Vallejo when we used to play Vallejo High. They used to come, Vallejo. DeMarcus Nelson, all them. I'm sure you can name all the people that played at Vallejo High. But I think that's kind of where it was, and it just kind of stuck around. But we changing that. The more people hear about it, the more people come. And man, it is what it is. Call us square, call us what it is, it's Fairfield. All right? Whatever you want to call it, but we here now. So accept it, we here.
So why run from where you from?
Yeah, like, the whole idea is to get the people together and run where y'all from, and run against, you know what I'm saying, as a unit.
Embrace where you're from.
Embrace where you're from. So, We doing that. And I think with collaborations, like with Dom, me and Dom consistent on collaboration. He's from Fairfield. I always make it a rule to collaborate with people from Fairfield. I make it a thing, like people that shot the video from Fairfield, for the most part, producers, Fairfield. I just try to spend my money in the community. I try to keep it community-centric, and you know what I'm saying? I think more people are getting excited. Like the people who were moving and shaking in Fairfield before we kind of brought the love back, got inspired, got motivated. And it's, you can see a lot of more pockets popping up. You can see things popping up, which we're proud about. Mm-hmm. That's what it's all about, like literally. And then more energy involved, you're going to see Fairfield every more, more places. That's the whole point, right? So I think we're spreading it.
Yeah. As far as like the logo specifically, like how hard was it to come up with that and put it together?
This logo right here, we did literally stencil this mug on this wall. Our bare hands, me and bro. But we came with this logo. It was from that first project, my first Fairfield I Love You project, date back to 2018. And that was kind of owed to Fairfield. I was in LA at the time. And we wanted kind of a university looking, a brand that almost signified not a school, but something that was a billboardish, billboard-esque. And the red is obviously synonymous for, you know, vibrations and alertness, and kind of the outline just accentuates it, but the heart is kind of the vessel of it. That's what's breathing. I think that's kind of what sticks out about the logo, because most logos, I don't know, it's just that heart sticks out initially. So we went with it in Fairfield, FF, when everybody was texting, anybody sent something, FF is what we text, like Fairfield, FF. We ran with it. So we got a few different variations, but for the most part, that's the one you're going to see.
How did you get into music? Like, how did that happen? Like, what was your introduction to becoming an artist?
Becoming an artist was, I think, like, fifth grade. Like, learning how to write, learning how to produce. Really young. On a computer, really young, SoundForge.
SoundForge, I
never heard of that either. I'm like, what is that?
I'm taking it back on y'all. Cakewalk, you ever heard of that?
Nah.
Cakewalk. I used to freak Fruity Loops. So Fruity Loops is kind of my first entry to like production.
Now you're talking. Yeah,
Fruity Loops. I used to freak that. Cracked Fruity Loops. y'all know about that. And that was kind of my introduction to be an artist, but I fell in love with music and got really successful and got interest and knew that this was something I wanted to do when deals, high school, signing autographs at the high, creating merch, basically running as a label in high school.
Yeah.
And that's when I fell in love with it.
Yeah. How'd you get into producer?
Growing up, my sister, she was always a singer, so she did like theater and like all that type of shit. And so one day my dad like bought her a bunch of like music equipment, like computers, speakers, all that stuff. And then so one day I was just bored, went on her shit, and just kind of like made like something stupid, but I was like, damn, this is hella cool, just made a little beat or whatever. I think I was like 16 17, and then from there I just kept doing that shit every day. And then I started taking it seriously probably like 2019. Started like really learning how to like play instruments and play with sounds and all that type of stuff. So, yeah.
What do you make your beats in now?
Ableton and Fruity Loops. Yeah, I'm trying to be proficient in like all four of the major ones.
Tell us like some of the people you produce for, some of the stuff you worked on.
Me and him are working on a tape right now. Well, it's already done. It's coming out next week, next Friday. Cali Winter 3.
Yeah.
But I've worked with Wiz, LaRusso. We're about to drop a tape on Sunday. DB Battle Bag, T-Fly, but that never came out. But I just like to say this. But, shit, I don't know. Just a lot of local artists, smaller artists, bigger. Like, not super big, but, like, I don't know, just random dudes.
Yeah.
Just, I don't know. Just, I kind of, like, right now I'm kind of changing my sound anyways. I'm trying to, like, move into a whole another lane. So it's kind of, like, hard to remember. But a lot of people from the Bay, for sure.
What advice could you give to up-and-coming producers that want to get into making beats, that want to do what you do?
Do that shit every day. Like, it's a day job. As long as it's fun, you gotta love it. Learn how to play an instrument if you can. Definitely, that changes everything.
Do.
Yeah, love it. Collaborate.
Collaborate.
Do good business. Don't be a fucking weirdo. Show your face. Don't be like one of those, like some producers, like they have no, like they'll have social media, but it's just all just beats. Like there's no, like, I don't even know what this dude looks like. Yeah. Type shit. It's just like, you want to be personable, because that's how you build relationships, and building relationships is how you get in the rooms with all these artists and stuff. So
yeah,
definitely.
No, I agree with you on that.
Brand yourself.
Yeah.
How important, y'all got branded down. Like, how important is that though? Like,
I mean, that's one thing that, like, any project we do, we like to brand the producer, because I know how a producer can get overcasted and overshadowed. We try to make sure all the back end is right, you know what I'm saying? But brand the producer, because that sound is so crucial. That sound, I tell this to a lot of people, that most listeners are gonna give the beat the chance first. If they don't like that beat within that first second, they turning it off.
Yeah.
Right. and
that's true.
For the most part, you ain't hearing
what you gotta say.
You ain't hearing a voice first, right? Yeah. Most songs you hearing the beat first. So hey, they very, producers are very crucial. So brand yourself as a producer, know your brand, know your worth, and try to create that signature sound.
Don't be afraid to work for free too, though. A lot of dudes be trying to charge and shit, and it's like, bro, you ain't even done nothing. Like,
at what point does a producer know that he can charge, though?
That's a good question.
Very good question.
Because sometimes it's not about that.
It's not.
But sometimes, like, for me, like, if it's someone I don't know, or, like, if I'm not, like, a fan of their shit, and, like, really, well, I also work outside of this, so, like, money for producing, like, I don't really care about, because I have a job.
I got you.
But, like, at the same time, I would love to go full-time. But, like, selling beats to, like, people that I don't really know about is fine. But, like, if I want to be a part of something, I don't mind, like, making a beat. It only takes fucking 30 minutes. Like, I don't mind doing that shit and then getting splits on the back end or whatever.
Yeah.
Because it's about, like, relationships at the end of the day.
No, I respect that for sure.
Yeah,
it's you gotta know your worth as a producer. But if you know you got the sauce, you know you can cook it up any day, at all times, right?
Right.
So you know that it's the relationships come once at a time. That check you can sell for a beat, or that 200 you getting for that beat, or that, you know what I'm saying, that 50 that you're getting for the beat or whatever, it's cool. But those relationships gonna last you forever.
Yep.
And I always see people like build a sound with a certain producer, or producers build, it's like better to come up with an artist. Like, don't ever underestimate that. Most of those legendary producers you hear now, they came with somebody.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, cultivate your sound, and don't be afraid to work for relationships.
Also, don't be afraid to say no to shit you don't like.
Absolutely.
That's a question, or not a question, that's like something I learned along the way. You're saying yes to everything, and it kind of hurts like your soul.
No, you like, do. You got to sleep with that. Yeah. You got to sleep with it.
You got to have your name attached to some bullshit that you don't want to have to be attached to, and it's definitely...
What can y'all tell me about the new project y'all got covered, Cali Winter 3?
Cali Winter 3. Third installment, the best one ever.
The best one.
The best one so far. And packaged right. This time, Dom came to the crib, literally brought his guitar, Didn't actually hook it up. It didn't work.
I was ready though.
But he was ready. He can play, okay? I seen him play, so I had to test him. He can play. A little bit. But he came through, unloaded the whole pack. It was like, hey, we gone. What you want? Literally chefed it up. We cooked, I think, like two or three of them there. I think one of them made it onto the project. But we chose the beats. We sat down with it. I told him kind of the vibe that I wanted and the themes of what I wanted the songs to sound like. You know what I'm saying? The landscape. And this boy can cook up anything. He literally has... it's funny because I'm about to say he probably got like 13,000 beats, some 1,300, something like that. And he said it like nonchalantly. I'm like, what are you talking about? 1,300 beats? Yes, he literally has.
That's insane.
More than that. But yeah, around, basically.
Dude, he literally has everything. And I'm like a producer, rapper, so I like weird pockets. And I like to showcase, you know, my writing ability and my styles. So I don't like everything the same, or at least in the same vein. But you get like it's five tracks, so you kind of get a preview of the sauce that me and Dom got, and it's this one is it's solid, it's really solid. The production. You happy with the production, right?
Yeah. Any features?
No features. I'm to the necklace with this one.
Why did you choose to do that?
All the Cali Winter projects have been to the necklace.
So you just kept it?
I like it to the necklace. All my other projects, I have had features, but you got to hear this. You got to hear me. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes collaboration can get overcasted with the quality of the song choice, with the songwriting, with the production choice, with my sauce on it. You know what I'm saying? So you got to hear my sauce. That's how we come.
As far as like your writing process and even with your beat selection, like what goes into that?
It's all over the place. It's all over the place. It's literally how I feel at the moment. It could be a premeditated thing. It could be bro got some ideas, hey, we need to hit this point. It could be, I just made a beat, I'm just gonna rap on my beats. It could be just to challenge myself just to rap. I like to work and create some every day. At least I like to try. So it's challenging myself. Like if I don't have no beats from other producers like that I'm working with or I'm not working on a project, I have beats and I'll challenge myself to rap over anything. Just, you never know what's going to come out of that. You never know. But some songs are thought of like months in advance or just I'm in the move of something or I see something on Instagram and literally I'm saying something all the time like, thank you, I'm about to say something I ain't supposed to say. Just natural stuff I'm going through. And I like to talk about the stuff that I'm literally doing as I'm going through it. So it's real-time music, real-time writing.
Do you always write? You punch in? Like, what is that process?
Both. Sometimes it'd be on my... I'm just going to punch in, be on my talking. You feel me? Sometimes it'd be like, I'm just going to write. Sometimes it'd be like, I write, then I come back and do the second half of the verse... not written, you know what I'm saying? Just punching in.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'll rearrange it. I like the hook. Sometimes I'll make the hook a verse. I'll rearrange that. It's just, I'll have fun with it, honestly. I have fun with it at all times.
Mm-hmm. Can you talk about Class Clown Records?
Class Clown Records, man. That's funny. That's kind of OG. We kind of revamping that right now. It's funny you say that because I'll be all bro.
What the fuck is that?
So Class Clown Records is kind of a throwback. So I was a class clown in high school. That's kind of where that came from, right? And we kind of branded that when we was on our back in the day stuff. And that's where that came from. But all of our music thus far has been put on that. So it's been kind of Class Clown, Fairfoot, I Love You. Above Money, it's kind of my own stuff.
Yeah.
That's kind of my like production or writing publishing. And for now, moving forward, it's going to be all Fairfoot. I love you. I told bro, we got to make sure it's all that. Because people might get the wrong thing. Back in the day, clowning was, you know what I'm saying? It's a different meaning towards it now.
Yeah.
Back in the day, it was clowning. You know, we clowning out here. Now, it's, you know, it's a different meaning. So I want to get it perceived a different way. So we revamping that. Mm-hmm.
When is the project dropping? Let the people know again one more time when it's dropping.
Cali Winter 3, February 3rd, 2-3-23. It just sounds good, right? 2-3-23, right? Yeah, Cali Winter 3, 5 songs, real package, right? Hella fun, feel right. Video out right now, produced by him and Foley Beats. It's some collabs on there with you, right? We got Foley Beats and
Hunger Force.
Hunger Force on that thing. Yeah, and it's a powerful project. It's a powerful project. It's going to be something that people going to talk about. It's going to be. It's a good representation of what Cali is like in the winter, because it's different. Cali different in the winter out here.
Yeah. The name, like, what is about Cali winter?
Because when you think of winter, you think of snow. Where we at, we don't really get the snow, right?
Right.
So it's almost like rain. And this is the first year we really got like the rain is supposed to come.
It was crazy out here.
Man, it's like, I think this is the first real Cali winter we had in a minute.
Right.
But that name is just like perfect. It's synonymous. It feels right for the moment. It feels right. Right? Cali winter. And nobody really, it's a seasonal project. It's a seasonal project. Like, it's only in season. Like when you go to Chick-fil-A and you need that peach milkshake, it's only in season for the time. So that's how it is, I'm telling you. And it got the whipped cream on the top. You had a cherry if you want. If you don't want it, you feel me? But the project got something for the ladies. Guilty Pleasures. They produced that one, him and Foley Beats. That one, that's a, man, I could hear Stevie Wonder on that thing, man. And I'm going stretching, but
yeah.
That is it's a beautiful rendition. It's like some player Stevie Wonder's type feel, you know what I'm saying? And then you got some game spitting. It's a lot of game. I be telling people, don't let the bars go over your head. I'm a seasoned rapper, I'm a seasoned human being. I've been around, I touch many hats. It's some pieces of gems you can find in everything, okay? So, listen to the lyrics. That's accompanying the production, because that production is A1. The lyrics is A1 with it's filet mignon. So you know what I'm saying? It's gonna be that perfect season, and I promise you that. It's the best work that we did together. I feel like it's my best work so far. Yeah, it's gonna be.
What would you attribute to this being your best work so far?
When people are excited about it, and I'm excited about it. This is the most excited I've been about a project. Every time I'm with somebody, I'm playing it. Bro hit me and was like, this is the one. You need to, you know what I'm saying, lock in. We need to make sure he needs to be broadcasted because he's the one. His sound is like, that his textures are signature to him, and they need to be broadcasted. And I think that the way that we picked these specific beats, we haven't done before. This is like, we literally curated this one. Do you feel this is the best one?
Yeah, for sure. So
for
far.
Sure, right?
I still got a few more, but yeah, for sure, definitely.
Yeah, I think this is gonna be the one.
If someone never heard a song for you, which song would you tell them to listen to?
Hella fun, probably, from this project.
Yeah.
From this project, Cali Plates, from probably the first one. You know, Cali Plates is, you know what I'm saying, a good representation of California. But all of them, I think if you entry into any one of these, you'll get a good picture of kind of me, and a good experience of the sound. Any entry point, Cali Prices is cold. That's the intro. But activated is on that player, you know what I'm saying? You just push that to get activated, turn you on, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then feel right is like, we in the night, we tripping, we having a good time. Because the bay, you know what I'm saying? It's a thing, right? I don't know if it's a thing, but y'all tell me, is shrooms a thing? Or is that like,
yeah.
Oh, it's a thing, right?
Yeah.
Shrooms a thing right now, I feel like.
I think it's more than ever now.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, I'm not just tripping, right?
More than ever now.
And I think it's more accepted. I feel like it's more accessible. Yeah, I feel like
it is.
More people are doing it. Yeah, like
it is. You're 100% right.
I feel like it's almost going to be like how weed is now. Weed, you get, it's almost, weed is like drank now, right?
No, it is. It is.
Shrooms is a thing.
It's
so
like the new wave.
I feel like this, that song is a good, like.
I'm excited.
I have not shroomed yet. So if y'all put me on, I don't know if.
Hey, man.
I haven't yet either.
Okay, okay.
I'm leaning towards it.
Right? Me too.
It's not everything that people say it is, but it's also like, I wouldn't go in there like, fuck the. But like, nah, it's cool.
It's cool. So I think you gotta go with that approach. It's cool. So we gonna do that. But nah, that's a hella fun. And then you got Smells Like Money. Smell Like Money. That song, that's the one we created at home, at the crib. He literally played the melody. I was writing. He wrote the drum. He played the drums, and the drums is on some it's on some Marvin Gaye drums. Back in the 70s, on some melodic, like...
Some little percussion type shit. It was light, though. It wasn't, you know, like, super, like, banging drums.
And that. Nah, super light. Super light, but a good soundscape. A good soundscape. And we literally dissected that. The lyrics on that is, like, on point. And that's from, like, Smells Like Money. You know what I'm saying? You can, you know what I'm saying? That's... But it's... Listen to the lyrics. Listen to the lyrics.
You've made a lot of beats in your career as well. Like, who are some of the people you produce for?
Man, I produce for Filthy Rich and Messy Marv on the same song.
Oh, wow.
Ironically.
Oh, shit.
That's crazy.
Ironically, right?
I'm like, wait, what?
It's called I Bet. I sampled Young Dro. Just the vocals on Young Dro. He say, I bet my car talk, and I bet my motor clean. I bet my car talk, and I bet my motor clean. And I have some banging ass drums, and it's Filthy Rich and Messy Marv. Go look it up. It's on iTunes right now.
No, that's probably like an old record.
I did something for Keek. They never came out. I got some things in the works right now I don't want to say. Fingers crossed, they come out. Okay, I got something with Stressmatic right now out. We just dropped it. It's called Work. That got that signature bass head sound. That's what I go by as a producer, bass head.
Yeah.
Cause all my beats be fat as hell, and they be too bass heavy. Like it be hitting speakers that I don't think it's supposed to be hitting in the car.
Yeah.
So I think they need to be turned down. But that's how it is. My bad. But yeah, I'm trying to think who else. Shoes Up Cheese, Cousin Feek. I'm sure I can go down. Yeah.
Quick question I want to ask for both of y'all, because both of y'all said this, but it's all y'all talking about songs you produced, but they didn't come out. How do y'all feel as a producer if the record doesn't come out? Are you upset by it, or can y'all use the beat with somebody else? Like, how does that work?
Yeah, if something's coming out or something that's not gonna come out, I'll still use the same beat.
Like, gotcha.
It depends on who it's for.
Especially Van Paper.
It depends on who it's for. I feel like sometimes the beat is for that person. I know the vision, and
true.
I ain't gonna trip. It is what it is. If the song too big for me. At least that one. Sometimes, and the game is funny, it ain't out to us out, right? It ain't out to us literally out. You just never know. So that's, you know, I think that's, you just never know. So just keep working.
Yeah.
Just keep working. And that's not your best beat. You know what I'm saying? Just as long as you keep working, you're going to find another beat. There's going to be plenty of beats. So... I don't tuck the beats. We used to have that conversation. Some people tuck beats. I guess as an artist, I think I was having this with Davito. He was telling me. Don't always tuck your beats, man. Sometimes Just get it. Let it out. Go.
Yeah, just go. Looking for what?
Just go. What's the plan for y'all after y'all drop the new project? Like, what else can people expect coming for y'all in the new year?
I don't know. Just I'm always doing music, so we're always gonna keep making music. So far, we've only done the Cali Winter shit. So
we can do some other stuff. Yeah,
for sure.
I definitely got some songs over his stuff.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah. But yeah, man, just always doing music and shit. So kind of just stay on that path.
Yeah, we definitely gonna do some music. We I think what Cali Winter 3. I got this project coming with Rob Savage. It's going to be, I think, 7-0 Sav or something. We're going to call it like that. Yeah. Something.
So what do you do, the 7-0
yep,
Savage?
Yep, something with him. I got something coming with Dre, host with the most.
Yeah.
Fairfoot I Love You 3. We working on that right now. He going to be a part of that. Mm-hmm. It's going to be something on there. Fairfoot I Love You 3 is going to be like, I don't even want to say like it's gonna be like a marathon. Let's put it like that. Like I don't know. It's gonna be the one. I feel like Fairfoot I Love You 2 was slept on. If you go listen back to that project, it's a solid Fairfield project. Like it's solid Fairfield factors on that thing, and the production is solid on there. And the writing is solid. I think we what are we gonna do? What else after that? I think something else. I got one more project. What? Elko Flows just dropped. Don't forget Elko Flows. Elko Flows is a good ode to kind of, it's a rendition of the car culture. Seven Deuce Elko. You know what I'm saying? My introduction into the game in terms of me getting on that classic thing. You feel me? Shout out. You know what I'm saying? Big GTO Earl put me in the game. He, what is it, with a 415 car club. I think he over there, 415 car club. Yeah, he put me in the game. Solid project. Dirty Shoes produced some of them things on there. Just kind of gave me the texture for that. But I think Juice on that mug, too. Juice from Fairfield, another producer from Fairfield. Shoes, another producer from Fairfield.
Shout out Juice.
Juice, a heavy hitter, too. We working on something. I just hollered at him. We got something coming, too.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. More clothes too. More clothes. We just getting started with the clothes. New collection coming soon. The field collection coming soon. Pape still coming. You know what I'm saying? We still on the Pape. And yeah.
People gotta come check out the store.
3067. 3067 Travis Boulevard, Fairfield, California, 94534. You know what I'm saying? We right here, right next to Huckleberry's, feel me? Rayleigh's, In-N-Out. Yeah, we got kicks. We got showcasing other local designers too. It ain't just about us. We do Freestyle Fridays where we putting on for the city. If you're a local artist, we probably already know you, but reach out to us. Make sure, you know what I'm saying, we showcase you because this is all about showcasing what Fairfield got. We finna showcase some producers too, cause there's a lot of producers out here that's being slept on. Okay,
yeah.
We finna do that, and Fairfield I Love You Day, mark that. Fairfield I Love You Day is gonna be something we planning out. We gonna get a guest. We working things out right now, and it's coming this year. We thinking it's gonna be around 7/07 day, which is what, July 7th.
Yeah.
That's what we're thinking. And February, my boy Don Prito, big mover and shaker from Fairfield, works with Golden Voice and all these, you know what I'm saying, other artists, and doing shows and booking shows. We're doing a free game workshop the 11th of February right here. So if you're an artist, it's going to be some people in here. It's going to be some guests in here, hopefully. But he's definitely going to be here giving game to any creative, any artist, anybody that wants to get into any type of entertainment or anything at this location. This is a free thing we're going to do. It's going to be, going to try to do it annually or monthly or whatever it may be. But We give a free game. I promise you these relationships you don't want to miss.
What is that? What is it?
February 11th.
Oh, okay.
February 11th. That's your birthday, huh?
10th.
Yeah, I know. You know. He's not going to be here.
He's like, why not?
That's the only day he works.
I'll be in San Diego.
That's the only day he works to come up here. He in L.A., so yeah. We got to orchestrate that, but don't miss that. It's not just for us. It's for the community, and more collaborations coming soon. Yeah, man. It's Fairfield.
You've been making music for a while. You've been in the music industry for a long time. What do you think, one, has changed the most in your music over the years? And I guess my part two would be like, what is one of like the biggest lessons you've learned since you've been in the music industry?
I think the biggest thing is you can do this by yourself. And I really didn't, I always grew up to be like, you gotta go get a deal. I was the ones that was like, we finna go to New York. New York, we didn't even think of LA. We was like, we're gonna go to New York. Da, 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 da. And with Bro, like, Bro kind of reshaped me. We come from the Bay, so we always had an independent mentality, but it wasn't always believable. It wasn't always actual. It wasn't always, we could do this. So I think that's one thing that changed. And with the industry overall in general, just it being, you can have a hit from your bedroom, literally, and upload it. You can record it, upload it right there, right now, and get all your back end.
Yep.
It wasn't like that before. It's a lot of gatekeepers. So I think the gatekeepers are exposing themselves, which it makes it more leverage for the artist.
And there's just so many ways to make content.
So many ways to make content. I think content is the king. You're absolutely right about that. Where you wasn't getting paid for content. It was almost, content was promotional. Whereas now you can get paid for your content.
Yeah.
Literally. And it shaped my music because I got more business. I know how the business is ran. Before it was just like, I don't know the business ins and outs. I don't know what I'm talking about, essentially. At least I'm reflecting of a feeling. Now I'm literally giving you guys my experience and games that, like, I have experience in the industry that most people do not have. That if you listen to these lyrics, you'll benefit from it. It's experience that I went through that you don't got to go through. Like, it's a record that most people don't know that I did. It's called Trapped in the Music, probably 4 or 5 years ago, that I had Julian Mitchell, All Things Mitch, who does a lot of work with Revolt, and does a lot of back-end stuff, but he narrated that project.
Yeah.
But if you go through that project, you'll listen to what I'm talking about. It's kind of like independent freedom, or the quest for independent freedom within that project. And it's packaged right. Go listen to that project. If you are on any type of, not against the industry, but navigating through the industry, and taking someone's experience that's been in the industry. But yeah, it's stages within my catalog. Like, the projects you can learn a lot of game from. Hopefully,
as you get older, you kind of have more experiences and you rap differently.
You do. Yeah. You absolutely do.
It's a difference between rapping when you're 30 and then when you're fucking 17. Like.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Experience, and just the game that you bestow. You know, what I realized that platform of me creating is to give the game off. It's not just for me to brag about or for me to be braggadocious.
Yeah.
That's literally the point for my testimony or my message, right? Is when we're creating music. And that's what's going to live forever. And people are going to take that and make it for themselves. It's not going to be in minds no more. You know what I'm saying? So I did that work for y'all. So y'all need to go listen to this stuff.
Yeah.
I swear to you, before it's too late. Or, you know what I'm saying? Before you can't experience it and get the from the real time, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I think that's shaped, and it's better for everybody in general, right, to get that experience.
Is there anything y'all want to address before y'all get out of here?
Fairfield is the Bay.
Fairfield is the Bay. Tell him.
I hate people say that shit.
Tell him, dog. Man. Nah, by your request. And we would have a political debate. Intervenor, set it up. Let's get some factors, okay?
Yeah.
It don't matter what people say. E-40 said it true. Was.
I believe it's the Bay.
And you a shaker, right? You're an influencer.
Yeah, I believe it's the Bay.
So if somebody come right. and tell you, a respected person, that and you were interviewing them, they're like, nah, Fairfield ain't the Bay. You gonna back us up?
I'm gonna be like, Fairfield the Bay for
okay,
sure.
Okay, now that you came here, you got to, okay? You got to. Hold this up. I'm gonna be on your comments on your YouTube like, hey.
Nah, I believe Fairfield is the Bay for sure.
Because you know it's history out here, right?
I don't even understand how that people are saying it's not the Bay. Like,
that's what I'm saying. Right?
And you from the rich.
You feel me? Like,
it's a lot of people from the rich out here, too.
For sure. It's a lot of people from the Bay out here. Like,
so,
exactly.
Let's just keep it lit. Like,
this technically, it's a little marsh over there that's connected.
We to right the here. Water. We right here to the water, bro. Like, if you from the sloughs, you know we right here. Like, very. Yeah. Come on now, let's just stop. Let's just unite, right? It takes. I was listening to something. I think Dame Dash said this earlier. The strongest man is the person that connects everyone. It's not just we not just isolated. So let's all come together, bro. Let's all come together. It's more money. It's for everybody. It's like, and I see a lot of people expressing it too. Like, why everybody this? It's because we not doing it. So when you see us spreading with love, show more love. Like, we putting people on. We ain't not discarding no artists from anywhere. We letting people come here and broadcast it. I'm paying for the video. I'm paying for it. So come on, man. We here to broadcast to everybody. I promise you. It's broadcast. There's no reason why we shouldn't be on top. We got people like LaRussell. Why are we not all putting them on a pedestal? You know, not pedestal, but like helping them. Let's all support. Let's all do this. He making it easier, accessible for people to come over here to Fairfield. We right here. You know what I'm saying? So let's all do it. We right here. We shouldn't be saying who not in the Bay. We should be all saying, yeah, they from the Bay. We should be including Sack in the Bay too. Because they the hot, probably hotter than the Bay. Right? To be lit.
If you're going to keep it real.
I mean.
Keep it real.
I mean.
But it's all.
It should be all one. All one.
We all NorCal. Forget it. That's why I say from San Jose up to
Northern California has such like a specific culture in general.
It do. And even.
You can like, go up to Sac and talk to a dude the same way as you would talk to someone from like Oakland.
No, you're right. Because even if you're in LA, if y'all don't know, most people in LA, they say Cali, but they don't think like. I don't know, it'd be weird. Like, they don't technically say the. I don't even know how to say it. This probably don't need to make this. But they don't think the Bay Area is California. I don't know, it's kind of weird. I don't know how to explain it.
California's too damn.
Like, they'll say, I'm from Cali, but I'm from the Bay, and they won't think that I'm from.
Do you know what I'm trying to say? I get what you're saying, because I live in LA. Yeah, they're not like. When they think of Cali, they don't think of the Bay at all. We're in a whole different world.
It's a whole different world. I swear to you. It's like, they say I'm. They'll say they're from Cali, but they don't think I'm from. They know I'm from the Cali, but they don't. I don't. It's just so fucking weird. I don't even know how to.
It is like a whole other world.
Though. It is a whole different world. Yeah. I promise you, whole different world.
Yeah.
But it's still all love, all California love for sure.
Cali Winter 3, dropping.
2/3/23.
Yes. Everybody tap in.
Yes.
I appreciate y'all letting me come to the store to get the interview in.
It's love.
Y'all make sure to come to the store, check it out, check the merch. They got shoes, new music coming soon, videos coming soon,
yep.
Freestyles dropping.
Yep.
Community.
Fairfield, I love you.
Community events, all that. We might start doing some interviews too. I might get back on my, you know what I'm saying? Because interviews is where it's at.
Do
you know
it.
What I'm saying?
Do it.
Everybody and their mama got a fucking podcast.
Do
they
it.
Do. But we're going to do it specific for Fairfield. Everything you know we do is for Fairfield. So I'm thinking of something like we're going to showcase Fairfield. Even businesses, legends, you know what I'm saying? Everybody. That's how we're going to do it. You feel me? So yeah, look out for that. But most stuff coming. And we bring everybody to Fairfield. We're bringing the cameras to Fairfield. If you see us, you're probably going to see that. It's just how we're going to do it. So y'all can stop saying Fairfield ain't the Bay, okay? But yeah, man, I appreciate you coming.
I appreciate y'all.
Appreciate it.
It's love, man.